Hey, what is up, Design Nation? In this session, I'm going to teach you how to make accurate and quick topography in Sketchup. I've imported this map of San Diego into my Sketchup file. And if you need to know how to do that, you can check the link below, and there is a video where I teach you how to import a map from Google Earth. But you want to make sure for this that you have your geolocation show terrain on, so that you have your topography. And then the next thing you want to do is make a rectangle. I'm going to hit R, which is the shortcut for that. I'm just going to draw a large rectangle and just make sure that it covers the whole map. Select it and move it to the lowest point, the lowest corner. So it looks like the one that I picked is right. And then the next thing that I want to do is select this. I'm going to group it. And I want my increment to be every 5 feet, so I'm going to hit, what I just did there is I hit Control to copy, and you can see it has the blue axis. If you're having trouble snapping, you can always hit the up arrow to lock to the blue axis. And I'm going to hit 5 feet, because I want to have a 5 foot increment of topography. I'm going to hit Enter. You can see it did a 5 foot there. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to type the asterisk symbol times. I'm going to type, let's say, 30. Didn't look like it was quite enough, so I'm going to do times 35 times 40. You can see it's slowly building up here. Times 45. I don't want to do too much, times 48, times 50. That looks good. So now what I need to do is, I actually need to select everything that's inside of this. So I'm going to move this off to the side really quick. Let's say, it actually can be. I need to unlock this, so I'm going to right-click and hit Unlock. And then I'm also going to explode it, because I'm actually going to cut this. Then I'm going to select all of these, and I'm going to group them. Again, group the groups. Make sure you don't have your map selected. Move it over, and then select everything, right click, and I'm going to hit Intersect Faces with Selection. This is going to take a little bit, but basically what it's doing is it is cutting. So you can see this, if I'm going to right click, hide this. You can see now I have my topography generated. So if you want to just have the lines here, you just right click on one of the faces and go to select all with same material, because it was made from the same photo, and just delete it, and you have your topography. So I'm drawing a rectangle here, so that it's on one plane, and I'm going to stretch this plane so that it is the size of the terrain, the topo that I just selected. And then what I'm going to do is move this down, explode it, and then what I'm going to do is select this line, select all this line work. Go to Tools, Sandbox, Drape, and select this face. It's going to take a little bit. You can see it's loading. now I have a two-dimensional a topo, if that's what you want. If you thought that this video was helpful, please subscribe, like, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers, just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.